Hey guys, what's up? It's Gunrak Singh and I'm back from Mogan's Boom. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about the stuff that has been added in the game and has changed the user experience completely. They have added many things in the recent update and in the past update, and I will be talking about all of them. And yeah, I will be showing you guys 2-3 gameplay so that you can, you know, enjoy the game and my commentary. So sit back, enjoy the video, and let's start. So first one will be Vest. They have added 3 type of vest and it gives you advantage and protects you from different type of damage. First one will be explosive damage, that's shell. And second one is Ifrit, it protects you from fire damage. And the third one is Zero, that's the one of the best vest I will say, because many guys use Odin and you know it has freeze damage, so it protects you from the freeze damage. And you know many guys still call Odin the god of assault rifles, because you can see that from the name. And yeah, it protects you from the freeze damage, and yeah, it gives you a great type of advantage, I will say. And same about the shell, you can get the shell from Gunbox, and 2 type of vest, Ifrit and Zero, you can get from gold. So shell is like a F2P vest, you can say, and it protects you from the explosive damage. Many guys are using launchers and stuff on the level 50 after the battle coins fear. So yeah, it's helpful for the F2P players to get less 20% damage when opponent is trying to, you know, spam launchers and stuff. So yeah, these are the 3 things. So we have talked about the vest system, and second one will be leagues. So league was the, you know, game changing decision by Guns of Boom guys, because I will tell you guys what was the advantage and disadvantage about the, you know, league change system. Because many guys were wanting to be on the top list of Guns of Boom, and many guys were, you know, trying and, you know, playing like day and night, and still were not able because of the one reason. The top players were having like millions of trophy, and 1, 2 million, 10 million trophy. So they were not able to, you know, get their fame, I will say, or, you know, get on top. So they were not playing that much. When the league system was introduced, they resetted the trophy. That was the best decision, I will say, because the rating was, you know, getting boring, I will say. They had to change the system, and they did. Many guys stopped playing after that, and many guys started to grind a lot, and they are still on top. After every 2 weeks, you can get a chance again to be on top. If you are active, you can be on top. So yeah, it was good decision for some players, it was bad decision for some players. Many guys, I also missed my trophy. I was about to get 400k trophy, but the decision was right to reset the trophy, I will say. At least the resetting the trophy, who were getting 1-2 million, they were sitting and relaxing and playing some games and still were on top one, like Microp was on top one and Bullet Baba. Most of the players were only on top because they started playing earlier than the players. The new players were not even close to be on top one, but now the new players who are active can be on top. So yeah, that's it. And the third one will be MVP screen. MVP means most valuable player. If you are one of the best compared to the 8 players, you have high amount of kills, high score, less amount of deaths, you can be on MVP screen. If you lose also, you can still be on MVP screen. So it can be a sort of achievement, I will say, and you can see yourself, you can use emotes, you can tease your opponents. If they lose, you can dance as well. You can see right here, I am on the MVP screen, I am having 432 score, and I am just using emote and stuff. So seeing yourself on the MVP screen gives you some sort of achievement, and I enjoy that, I can say. So this is the top 3, and top 4 will be the seasons. So every season we get a sort of new theme, I can say. We are on season 6 right now, and the theme is music. So everything like mask, costume, skins and stuff. So we will be getting new stuff every season. Every time there will be new theme, new skins, new costumes. So we can grind for many things in different season, and it gives you know, the game some sort of freshness, I can say. And that's the thing we need in a game. If you want to play a game, there should be anything, you know, many things new, so that you can grind more and more and you play more without getting bored. So season 6 is going on and I'm enjoying that, I can say. So top 4 will be the seasons. Top 5 will be esports. So many of the teams, you know, participated in esports tournament, like in season 1, season 2, like Jug Clan, Impact Gaming, Back to Back Gaming, Noble, and Cyclone GG from India. And many of the teams, like I also participated in esports weekly tournaments. The prize pool was $400. Weekly, I am saying, and in the seasons there were like $50,000, and you know the prize pool was huge. So esport is a big change in the, you know, gaming community. If your game can you know, equally manage esports and they can be successful, the game will be on, you know, on another level, I will say. And recently the partnership with the Guns of Boom and ESL is over, so this time all the tournaments and everything will be organized and, you know, handled by Guns of Boom team and stuff. So it will be fast, quick, and I'm just waiting for it. Maybe this will be, you know, best decision of Guns of Boom, and yeah, so just hope for the best. So esports is on top 5, I will say, and top 6 will be weekly brawls, you can say. Weekly brawls like Pro Play Aim Brawl or Aim Assist Off Brawl, you can say that, or you can say Heal and Run Brawl, Rocket Party Brawl, Rocket Launcher Party Brawl, and, you know, Arms Race Brawl. So many of the brawls that you know, that is a favorite of Guns of Boom community. I personally like Pro Play you know, Aim Assist Off Brawl, and that's one of my favorite. So top 6 will be weekly brawls, and top 7 will be the new events. And new events, you know about the Cyberfall event, Trio tournament event, or you can say the New Year event, or the recent one, Cope War event, and the Lunar Festival event, and there are many events that has Halloween event. Yeah, one of my favorite Halloween event or the New Year event was one of my favorite, you can say. And these type of events are, you know, basic need in a game. If you want your players to play regularly, if you want your players to be entertained with the new stuff, the events are the basic need of a game, and that has been fulfilled by Guns of Boom. So top 7 will be events, and top 8 will be the fear of the battle coins that has been recently, you know, introduced for the first time. Many guys were collecting their battle coins from like ages, I will say, and Guns of Boom gave them like 8 options, and 2 of the guns were decided by community on the Instagram polls, and like Bastion, Firefly, Odin, Avalanche, and Hero, Machine Gun, Kingslayer. Kingslayer was, you know, one of the things that many guys were asking for, and, you know, Guns of Boom fulfilled that. Many guys were not happy with the decision, but you can't, you know, make everyone happy, because I was also waiting for Eye, but Eye has been just released in Battle Coins right now. So yeah, I'm okay with that, but many of the guys were happy. They got Firefly, Bastion, Ordain, Avalanche, and most of the guns in free because they collected their Battle Coins. So Battle Coins will be top 8. Top 9 will be the cosmetics and emotes. So cosmetics and emotes, many of the guys know, you can recently see my costume, you can see right here. So I got that for 800 rupees. It's like $10, maybe less than that, but yeah, 800 rupees. So you can see the costume. If you like this type of cosmetics, there are different type of seals and different type of skins and costume. If you want them, just buy them with real money. It's for real money. If you are F2P player, I understand that. But emotes, you can, you know, gather them easily from you know, battle carrier. If you are F2P also, if you want to buy it with gold, you can also buy that, and if you are F2P, you can also buy that. So, you know, it's up to you guys. So cosmetic and emotes will be top 9, and top 10 at the end will be new maps. Every time a new event comes, there is a new map, most of the time 80 to 90%. Like in Halloween, we got new King of the Hill map. In like New Year, we got Push the Cart map, and recently we got in Trio tournament also. In Trio tournament, we got 2-3 new maps, and recently in the Corp of Wars, we got Island Ruin map. So every time new event comes, Guns of Boom surprises us with the new map, and that's what we need, man. Every time new maps, because most of the time, like if you play on 2-3 maps in 1 year, you will be, you know, you will get bored. So if you need your game to be successful and you want your players to be happy, there should be like in 4 to 5 months, at least 4 to 5 months, there should be a one new map, so that we can have you know, new experience to play and different type of maps to play. So right now we have around 10 to 15 maps, and yeah, it's good, and maybe we will get more map. Maybe in future there will be 30 to 40 maps, maybe more than that. Maybe my counting is wrong, but yeah, you understand that. So maps, new maps is really important in the game. So yeah, I am happy with all of the top 10 things. So these are the top 10 things that has changed the user experience of the Guns of Boom community and the players completely. And yeah, many guys are, you know, happy with the stuff. Many guys are not happy with the stuff. Like most of the guys want lag to be, you know, game to be lag free or hacker free. I understand that because, you know, I was also having a low end devices. The basic thing is the lag. Okay, many guys are asking to lag to be removed. I understand that, but in high end devices, like you can see right here, I am playing on OnePlus 60. The game is running smooth AF. The game is smooth. You can see right here, there is no lag, and you can check my ping, it's 80 to 90. So I don't experience any lag. Okay, 90 to 99% I will say the game is running smooth for me. The main thing is because it's a high-end device, in iPhone, in OnePlus 60, in OnePlus 7, I will say most of the high-end devices, in Razer, most of the high-end devices, the game is running smooth. But the low-end devices with 1 or 2GB RAM, they are facing some issues. So I want one thing from Guns of Boom, maybe they can, you know, balance the game for the low-end devices so that it can run smoothly. I play on 60 FPS, so my games run, you know, smoothly. I have no problem in lag or, you know, smoothness. My game is smooth. But for the, you know, low-end devices, I wish Guns of Boom can, you know, fix the stuff for the low-end devices players. And yeah, maybe they are working on it. Every time Guns of Boom surprises, their dev team is working for it. So hope so in future, if low-end devices are, you know, facing some trouble, it will be fixed. And the hackers. In the end, I will be talking about hackers because I have talked everything good about Guns of Boom. But the main thing that, you know, many players are frustrated about is lag. I have talked about it. And the hackers, you know, no one likes to play, you know, against hackers, okay? And many games like PUBG, Call of Duty, the games which are not released yet, and still they have hackers, okay? PUBG has a lot of hackers. Many of the guys who play PUBG will agree with me. So every game will have hackers, guys. We can just report them and spec them, or, you know, make video about them, and we have to work together and report these players. You can see the option on every profile and you can just click on it and report the player. And I have made a Discord server so that I can report hackers. I, you know, directly contact devs and stuff so that, you know, I can, you know, do my part and report hackers. So we can work together. Every game will have hackers. We can, you know, stop saying that, you know, this game is only having hackers. Every game has hacker, guys. So if we can just work together, maybe one day with all of our, you know, working together, this game will be hacker free. And I want that, okay? So hope so everything that, you know, community is saying, Guns of Boom, listen to them, and lag and hacker will be fixed. And most of the thing, yeah, hope you guys enjoy the video. Thanks for watching, like, subscribe and comment, and yep, peace out.